So most people, and research in all kind of countries substantiates this, at the end of their life, they would really like to be at home, wherever home is for them. So for the percentage of Canadians, say 15% of Canadians who live in a rural community, it means that they want to be in that community at the end of their life, with their family, with their friends, in their familiar surroundings. And so staying in an urban center where they may have access to specialty palliative care services is often not their preference. They don't want to be away. So the challenge is to work in the rural communities with the, what I would call, kind of frontline primary care healthcare providers, family doctors, community home care nurses, hospital nurses, and helping them organize themselves and supporting them to do what needs to be done to really make sure that individuals can die at home with comfort and dignity, which is, of course, what palliative care is all about. So I've been studying with the providers how we can best make that happen for them, really taking my leadership from them. So what they tell us they need is, first of all, they need to get a little bit organized for when someone is an expected death. One of the challenges in rural communities is that this isn't an everyday occurrence. So maybe five times a year or once a year, they would have someone who was dying at home and needing palliative care. So you don't have a formalized program that is ready to take off the shelf. So they need to spend some time together. They usually form some kind of a local palliative care team or committee, which is mostly about them talking to each other about how they can support each other and make sure that people are informed about what one another's role is, how can they contact each other, what can they expect others to do. If there are hospice volunteers in the community, how can they be contacted, how can they contribute. And so they kind of develop a local pathway of care or protocols, so then they know what to expect from each other. Then they need to let the community know what to expect. So they often spend some time developing a brochure for the community that explains the services and how to contact them and that sort of thing. Because if community members don't know that it's an option to come back home, they will often reluctantly opt to stay in an urban center. So that's the kind of thing that they do, and then they need education. So we've worked with them to identify some educational needs and delivered education to them about palliative care. And then even though they have good expertise, they also need consultation, because things come up always from time to time that they need to reach out to some of these expert palliative care specialists. And so we make sure that they're connected at a regional level to somebody that they can call that can help them out in a situation where they need some advice, or maybe just reassurance that what they did was the right thing to do. The other thing that is both really great about rural palliative care and a challenge is that if the healthcare providers are located in the community, which is when it works best, their local community members, they also have personal relationships with the people that are dying. And that helps them, I think, be more sensitive to their individual needs. It makes the family feel more comfortable and more trusting, because these healthcare providers are also the same people that go to their local church, or they see in the community center, or you know, they're involved in different ways. But it also means, I think, that they feel a lot of responsibility to make sure that things go as well as possible. So they benefit by having just really somebody to reassure them that they're making good choices with the patients and their families. We've been organizing courses where the specialists go out into the rural areas and we'll deliver a weekend course with the local providers, bring them together, and that fulfills two things. One is they get knowledge and skills, but they also have a chance to work together on that weekend in the education sessions and discuss a lot of these issues so that they want to learn to work well together as a team. And a lot of that is facilitated by the palliative care education. One of the things that is again a real positive thing about rural communities, and here I'm not talking about urban bedroom communities where people live but don't really work there. I'm talking about communities that are intact in the sense that people kind of live and work in them. And there really is a culture of social support that's embedded in those communities. So it's not uncommon for the neighbors and the local, you know, kind of church groups or voluntary groups to really organize themselves and support the families. We also want to make sure that they have some kind of education about how they can be most helpful. Because like anybody, people, they want to be helpful, but sometimes they don't really know how to go about being as supportive as they can. And hospice volunteers are a wonderful resource in rural communities because they do have training. And I've had them described to me as, these are my friends with skills. And the kind of volunteering is more informal. They meet each other on the street. They meet each other in the grocery store. The volunteer who is possibly also the neighbor stops and has a chat, drops over for coffee. So the blurring of the lines between the clients, the volunteers, and the professionals is something that really makes the care very person-centered when it works well.